All right, so we know that the Senate is negotiating its health care proposal and that it's largely being done behind closed doors. In fact, some Republicans say they don't even know what's in the bill. Meantime, we're entering day nine today. Would be day nine without a White House press briefing. Why? Why isn't there more transparency? Let's discuss with an informal advisor to President Trump, Anthony Scaramucci. Good to have you on, as always.
Hey, great seeing you, Chris.
Day nine, this odd thing where Spicer will talk, but it's got to be off camera. Why? Well, why these kinds of games with transparency?
You're putting me in a tough spot because I'm not in the meetings, and so I don't necessarily know the exact reasons, but it appears from the outside, at least for right now, is that they're going to redesign the communication strategy, and they'll probably, maybe Sean will go to another role inside the White House, or we'll put somebody else behind the podium.
You think that's likely that they'll move him?
I don't know. I mean, I've read some of the press speculation. Some of the people that I've talked to inside the White House are saying that they're exploring a couple of different ideas. I mean, this is one of the things that I do like about the president. You know, he's an entrepreneur, and he'll experiment and do different things. I think he's very loyal to Sean. I think Sean is a very hardworking guy. He's got great communication experience, and he may be the communications director or maybe even an assistant to, you know, Reince Priebus or something like that. Hard to really know from the outside, to be candid. But what I do like is that they're going to try to experiment, and I think maybe that's why they're off camera for a short period of time.
All right, so we'll see which way it goes. And with the president, in terms of the transparency there, that's the gift of Twitter, right? You know what's on the president's mind, often what's in his heart. The White House finally owned that, of course, these are official statements from the president of the United States. Doesn't matter what account they're coming from. He has not said to the UK, you know, I don't know what's happened privately, but publicly, condolences for this most recent attack. The speculation is, well, maybe it's because it involves Muslims. Maybe it's because he's got a problem with the mayor there. Why do you think he hasn't said anything, even just offering condolences?
Well, listen, he's an emotional guy. You saw the condolences that he offered yesterday as related to the North Korean situation. Again, I wouldn't know exactly why he's doing that. I think some of the speculation in the press is that he swore at the London mayor. That's not the president's style. That's not his mojo. And so my guess is that he probably will very shortly offer condolences if he hasn't done it publicly right now. And again, maybe he has done it privately, Chris.
In the past, he's done it very quickly.
But here's the point. I think you're trying to make is that could it be because of the way that attack was versus other attacks?
Well, when something's outside the norm of how he usually behaves after an attack, you have to ask why is it different.
Yeah, but you know, I mean, here's the biggest problem with the whole system, in my opinion. I mean, not only are you inside a bubble, but then you have all of us examining you inside the bubble. You're in that little fishbowl, and so it could be just that for whatever reason he didn't do it. Now it could have.
But he's in no bubble. He's probably watching right now, and he's going to comment on your tie and your hairstyle. He's watching.
Well, he likes my tie and my hairstyle, but he doesn't like your tie.
He doesn't like anything about me. I understand. I understand.
Maybe your hairline. That's about it.
I don't like my hairline.
Probably very little.
Don't distract me, Scary.
Probably very little about that he likes, actually. But that's
why is it different though this time? Why do you think?
I don't know. I don't know the answer. But here's what I do know about him. Okay, number one, what he said about the North Koreans, I think they should take that seriously. You know, we're going to.
What did he say though?
Oh, he said that we're tough enough to hear. This is there's a brutal.
He said we'll handle it.
We'll handle it. Yeah.
What does that mean?
He said if you remember, there's
might be a potential homicide of an American.
100-day period after he met with President Xi. He's asked for the help from the Chinese government. He has moved things around militarily to send a signal that he's going to handle the North Korean situation with or without the help of China. My guess is that China is going to take this seriously and work in concert with the president to help reduce the tension.
We haven't seen anything out of China. Now, fair point. So the Trump White House got Otto Warmbier home. That deserves credit.
Also the Egyptian prisoner. I can't remember.
No, absolutely. But I'm saying in this case, with Otto Warmbier, they got him home. The Obama administration could not do it. That warrants kudos. However, if this is judged a homicide, which means this young man's death came about because of human action, that's on North Korea. And the question will be, well, if that doesn't demand a muscular response, what does? And I'm only putting it in those terms not because that's the right thing to do, but it's because what the president said he would do.
And he said it yesterday. And he's very, look, Again, you can like the president or dislike him. I happen to love the guy. And let me tell you, when he says something like that, he certainly means it. And the world should wake up and pay attention to what he's saying. Because at some point, the American government and the president have to respond to people like the North Koreans. You know, if you've got concentration camps in North Korea, which you and I both know about, and this has been allowed to persist for 60 or 70 years, at some point, moral people have to look at that in concert with the global community and eradicate it. And so what I love about the president, he means what he says. He's not really a politician. Yes, he's 2 years into his political career, but he's really an American businessman who will respond effectively to this situation and catch people off guard with his response as well.
Another situation that I need help with understanding. The president says what he means. I agree with you most of the time. And when he was tweeting about this Russia investigation, he clearly doesn't like it because he believes that whatever is going on is bad for him. And so he puts Jay Sekulow out there, his attorney, to argue that he is not under investigation. Why? Why take on such a small point that defies the obvious?
Well, I think there's a number of different reasons. I mean, I can give you my reasons. I can't necessarily give you the president's reasons, but I think what the president sometimes does, he's a media, you know, this is good for you, probably good for ratings. The president is watching, he's reading a lot of stuff, and he probably doesn't like a lot of the stuff that he's reading that he thinks is very unfair. We can disagree about this, but the mainstream media, in my opinion, has not been fair to the president. They weren't fair to him when he was a candidate. They're not fair to him today. I don't think he's under investigation, but I don't know the facts, because I'm not the FBI. I'm not Robert Mueller. But
there's
no reason to believe that Mueller
wouldn't be looking at the situation surrounding the firing of the director
of the FBI. I understand that, but when James Comey tells the president several times that he's not under investigation.
Right, but that has nothing to do with whether Mueller would look at the firing. James Comey couldn't have told him, you're under investigation for firing me. He wasn't fired.
I understand that.
I know, but you guys keep bringing up Comey, telling him he's not under investigation.
You're making great points.
All right, go ahead.
Your viewers are loving you for the great points, but let me make a great point.
Go ahead, okay? Make your point.
Jay Sekulow is a phenomenal attorney. The president has done nothing wrong. I said that to you last week from Washington. I'll say it to you today. I can stand by that very confidently. I've known the guy for many, many years. And I think his integrity as a human being in a situation like that, I think, is unquestionable.
All right, but here's what I'm saying.
But let me finish.
Well, I want to ask a question about your point. All right,
Right? Yeah.
You say, well, we have a problem.
Done nothing wrong, Chris.
Right.
That's my point.
And I'm saying that's fine for you to hold that opinion. There's an investigation going on. We'll see what it yields. Comey told the president he wasn't under investigation. Fine. What does that have to do with Mueller examining the circumstances surrounding the firing of Comey?
So you're saying that he's under investigation by Mueller surrounding the circumstances?
I'm saying that it
Comey?
Makes sense that President Mueller would be looking at it. Comey said as much in his testimony.
I mean, it was 30 years ago, but I did take constitutional law from Larry Tribe at Harvard Law School. The president has the right to fire the FBI director. The president also got information and a recommendation from the deputy. He did tell Lester Holt that he would have fired him anyway. And he made a decision to fire the FBI director. Now, if you want to say that he made that...
He said more than that to Lester Holt.
I understand that, but we're talking about this specific issue in
the
investigation.
On this specific issue, he said more.
But let's stay on this issue.
I'm saying there's more.
I'm right here with you, brother. Let me finish the point.
Go ahead.
I'm right here with you.
Go ahead.
Here's the point. The president said he would have fired him one way or the other. He has the right to do that. People in the media are suggesting maybe he fired him as a way to obstruct justice on the Russian situation.
Because what did the president say to Lester Holt?
What did he say, Chris?
He said, I had Russia on my mind, and I was thinking, you know, this whole Russian thing, I don't like what Comey's doing about it. I fired him.
You see, here's the thing about you that
He means what he says, right?
I genuinely like this about you, and you're very good at this. You're probably really good at crossword puzzles, too. But let's stay on this point. Okay, the president did nothing wrong. He fired the guy because he had the opportunity to fire the guy. He didn't think he was doing the right job for him. He has the right to fire him.
He has
when
the
he
right
said,
to fire
when he said
him,
that he had Russia, when he
why,
said he had Russia on his mind, it's not because he did anything wrong. He's sitting there frustrated at the notion that
he doesn't like the Russia probe.
Because it's a hoax.
He doesn't like
it's
that's what he
it's
thinks.
More, so you, it's more fake
it's
news.
Certainly
it's
certainly not a hoax.
It's fake scandal, fake investigation.
No, 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 no.
Yes, it is. As
Anthony,
it relates,
you don't believe that.
Chris, I do believe that.
You don't believe
collusion.
All right, that's something separate.
Campaign.
That's something separate.
But we're arguing two different things.
But you guys conflate them. Investigating why Russia interfered and who may have helped all matters. Yes,
the president has been very clear about that.
Not so much.
He has.
Not so much.
Been clear privately.
He calls it a hoax and a witch hunt. He doesn't ever say, let's find out what happened with Russia.
Calls it a hoax and a witch hunt as it relates to the
investigation.
As it relates to the investigation of him and his campaign and his campaign staff.
And James Comey says the president talked to him 9 times and never asked him about the Russia investigation into the election interference. What does that tell us? It tells us he doesn't care about that. He cares about what happens to him and any allegations of collusion because it hurts him politically.
Okay, so this is where I'm going to totally disagree with you on
that.
And I'm going to be very respectful to you. The president does care. The president has said on more than one occasion that once all of the facts and all the findings are unveiled, that he would act in a judicious way as it related to Russia and other countries if other countries are in the problem.
And he keeps calling the process a hoax and the people who are doing it bad issue, and conflicted.
Your issue, okay, which I respect, but you should respect my issue. And my issue is...
You are here because I respect your take.
Okay, all right, so let me give you my take. The president has an agenda that's going to help the American people, lower middle class families and middle class families. These sorts of scandals and these hoaxiness nature to some of these scandals has got to be very frustrating to an American businessman that is now the commander-in-chief and the president. He wants to execute his agenda, Chris. He wants to bring the Congress together and get wins on the board for the American people as it relates to health care reform. Democrats know that that has to be reformed as well as the Republicans. We may disagree on the nature of the bill, but we all know that the Obamacare situation has to be reformed. Number two, we haven't reformed the tax code since 1986, Chris. That's a generation plus 6 or 7 years of no reform of the tax code. We have to fix the tax code. Number three.
We're waiting to hear what the plan is.
We're waiting to hear what the plan is, but we're so distracted by all of this
nonsense. You know, you can't say that the Russia situation doesn't matter. It just does,
Anthony. Why don't we get guests on New Day to talk about health care?
We do.
Guests
we do. We have them on all the time. And by the way, a lot of you, the Republicans, won't come on to talk about it.
Okay. Well, you're a tough interviewer, Chris. Maybe they don't like your suit.
Talk to Allison. Everybody likes her.
We'll have Allison talk to these people, okay?
But they can all come on. They say no.
My point, I'm going to stay on my point. Okay? He's a great guy. He's a moral leader. I think he'll handle the North Korean situation. I think he will execute on taxes and health care. And my guess is that when this is all over and there's no there for the president, I hope people in the mainstream media will vindicate him. When they were railing on him and writing all these op-eds that he's the worst guy ever and shouldn't be the president, and he made it to the presidency, I think the New York Times had to have a little bit of an apology and a comeuppance. And my guess is that when this investigation is over, the smart people in the media, the objective, fair people in the media, will have to have a little bit of a comeuppance and say, hey, there was no there related to the president, his campaign team, and the administration. Now, there might be a there related to collusion, you know, to activity, not collusion, but activity related to the Russians. Mm-hmm. It's a totally different topic. And I do believe that he will handle that aggressively.
There's certainly a relationship between all the different questions being asked. Mueller should be allowed to do his job, and then we'll see what comes out of it. Anthony Scaramucci, always a pleasure. Thank you very much. Allison.